Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and today we're going to talk about 70-332 Advanced Solutions for Microsoft SharePoint Server 2013. It's one of the MCSE for SharePoint exams. And with me, I'm delighted to have Mr. SharePoint himself, Bill Baer.
Thanks, Jay. Thanks for having me here today in the studios. I'm Bill Baer. I'm a Senior Product Marketing Manager in our SharePoint product group. On a day-to-day basis, I focus on our IT professional audience, making sure that they have the tools and the information they need to be successful with our product. I'm also a Microsoft Certified Solutions Master, and I've also instructed the Microsoft Solutions Master's courses.
Well, fantastic. So, Bill, this exam starts off with business continuity management. What the heck is that, and why do I want to manage it?
Well, Jay, let's take it very simply. Business continuity management is really the aspect of keeping SharePoint alive, keeping it up, and keeping it available to make sure it meets the business needs of an organization. So what does that mean? Effectively, most people think about business continuity management, and the first thing that pops into their head is SLA. SLA, obviously, is an acronym for Service Level Agreement, and you may be familiar with it measured in a number of nines, 2 nines, 3 nines, 4 nines, and 5 nines. So really, if you think about business continuity management, it's the sum of its parts. It's high availability, disaster recovery, and the ability to respond to failure.
So we also cover planning of different workloads. There's tons of stuff that you can do in SharePoint. It's a smart product. Can't I just turn on stuff like search or social and just let it run?
All too often, people kind of think of SharePoint as an application that you can just set it and forget it. And unfortunately, from that perspective, you really need to do the homework and the background to ensure that you have proper capacity and that you have proper performance to service the needs of the users, and particularly when you think about search, to service the needs of the content that you're actually going to present to those users by virtue of queries executed by those users. So it's really important to understand how much content am I going to index from a search perspective. How much content do I want to show my users? How performant do I want it to be? And then again, if we go all the way back to business continuity management, you also have to think about what happens when it fails. How do I plan for that? So it's not necessarily just turn it on and let it go. It's performing the proper analysis up front and then providing the service to the users.
Well, and of course, there would be not a Microsoft exam wouldn't be complete without upgrade questions. What are some of the things that you really have to focus on and be aware of when you're upgrading or migrating to SharePoint 2013?
I think one of the great things is if we look at upgrade in this particular release, it has gotten substantially better over time. If you think about from 2007, the investments we made there, the investments we made in SharePoint 2010 related to visual upgrade, and now we're in a world where we have a deferred site collection upgrade. Effectively, we're giving you the ability to upgrade the schema of a database as opposed to the site collections and its subordinate objects. It doesn't necessarily mean less planning, but what it does mean is upgrades faster, and it's also more resilient. There is still planning that you need to do. You need to inventory your customizations, understand how you're going to manage those customizations, whether they're candidates for our new cloud application model, or whether or not you want to continue down the path of traditional development. Those are kind of the core areas, customization and any branding that you may have done. Those are really the aspects that I would very briefly or very briefly summarize as those things that you need to look at.
So when you mentioned branding, is branding something, can I make my whole SharePoint infrastructure look like my Contoso Corporation?
Absolutely, and that's one of the most commonly performed customizations that we see today with organizations that are using SharePoint. It's really aligning SharePoint to the brand of your business.
Okay. You know, lots of times people come up to me and they ask me about Application Federation, which is weird because I don't know anything about it. So can you explain to the folks why that's important and why they need to know it?
Well, I think the answer to that's pretty easy. We live in a global economy. And in a global economy, more and more SharePoint deployments have become more and more distributed. Effectively, what that means is you want to make information available to people, but you want to provide them a unified user experience. The ability to federate applications or have a primary service application environment ensures that you have one instance of the applications that you want to provide to your business, but you have multiple SharePoint environments that can consume that functionality. And really, it provides users that unified experience and aggregates all the information in one place.
You know, I want to wrap up by talking a little bit about BI. I think that BI is something we historically didn't cover in the IT Pro exams. And now we're starting to bridge that gap. And the subject matter experts that we came in that told us and helped us figure out what should be on the exam really felt that it was important to lay down that BI infrastructure so that they can hand it over to the devs. Can you explain what sorts of things an IT pro would need to know about BI?
It's a great question. So today we obviously live in the world of big data.
Yep.
And it's important to be able to provide that information to your users, and it's also important for those users to be able to react against that information. That's where business intelligence comes in. And we've invested significantly in business intelligence from a SharePoint perspective over the course of the last three releases in particular. So it becomes more and more important that IT pros understand business intelligence and the uniqueness of business intelligence and as it applies to the actual users who would collect and use that data.
Okay. Well, thanks so much for being here, Bill. I really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me today.
So today we have been talking about 70-332. It's the advanced solution of Microsoft SharePoint Server 2013. It's the second exam in your MCSC for SharePoint. So go out, take that test, and get certified.